So the simulation also depends on the sector that we are talking about. If we are looking at some technology sector, you will see that there is a lot of growth in that sector. That sector is booming more today than ever. If we talk about the defense sector, it was booming in the time of 2002 to 2005. At this time, it's coming down. When we talk about the healthcare sector, again, it's booming. When we talk about the consumer sectors like food and retail, these are also booming. So the sector would also define what kind of a simulation we are going to use. So I'm coming back to the older idea of how we are going to look at things. So when we look at things, we have got present, we have got some data extract that we can get from the past, and we have present and the past and the projection of the future. So when we look at present, we are fixing this frame of time. So we are going to see what's happening today. So what is the company's leverage in the sector as compared to its multiple? So is there a linkage between a highly levered company with their high multiple or things like that? Or is there a relation between how much dividend a company is paying based on their leverage or their sales growth or their output? So we are fixing a frame today, and we are going to first look at what's in this frame for easier understanding. The next step would be we would go back. We will use a multiple linear regression equation to find out what is defining a company's leverage and EV multiple. That would be step two. And step three would be we are going to use present, past, and we are going to project future to find out how a company's sales would look like using the Monte Carlo engine. So we are basically dividing the analysis into three sections that would make our work easy, and it will make things very clear. When you look at how a multiple is defined for a sector, you have to be very careful. So if you are making a multiple linear regression equation for how a multiple is defined in a sector, that equation would be very similar to the entire sector. So if you talk about the technology sector and you build an MLR and you say that in the MLR industry, companies have multiple ranging from 10 to 15, maybe five out of that 15 or one third is explained by leverage, or one third is explained by sales. Some part is explained by distribution. So if a company tweaks in a distribution, that would raise up its multiple and in turn raise up its price. So that's where it becomes interesting. So this is the entire 360-degree view where we have present, past, and the future in our analysis.